kids, Rex here again. Welcome back to the second week of distance learning. This is day one, today's reflection question. What are ways you're keeping active? It's important to get out and walk while maintaining social distance and exercise. Are you doing push-ups? What kind of things are you doing to get all that physical energy out? Hope you're staying healthy. Hey, thanks, Rex, and aloha. It's Friday. That's a habit I've picked up from visiting Hawaii a few times. I've had several friends live out there, and it's a beautiful place, and they like to do Aloha Friday, Aloha shirts. I've got my Aloha shorts on. Ooh, and I forgot to put my flippy floppies on, too. I've got my flippy floppies. I've been eating some almonds, so if I cough, it's only because of the almonds. It is Friday, April 3rd, although you're watching this on April 5th, Monday, or Tuesday, April 6th. I'm recording this this session when it's snowing out there. It's 27 degrees, and I've got snow on the ground outside my apartment. So I'm going to keep this closed. I just thought I'd share that with you. All right, we've got four things on our agenda. I've got a bonus assignment. I'm going to check in with you about your habit-forming activities and where you're at with your project and just set some expectations with that. But four things that we need to do is review the distance learning schedule. This might be some of your first times watching my videos, so I'm going to review for you expectations on what distance learning looks like, what it does not look like, and how much content your teachers are going to produce for you. Two, I'm going to review my new document. I told you it was coming last week. I didn't get to it. It's live in Schoology. It's called Mr. Ermer's Contact Information. I'm going to just kind of talk about what teachers are expecting from you. I'm going to be talking about ways to contact me, and I'll go over that a little bit. Third thing is Schoology updates. I know we've had our first week of distance learning. It was frustrating. It was slow. I'll talk a little bit about some updates that I know about Schoology that might help you navigate your way through that. And then the fourth thing is, if you're in my language arts class, I know a couple of you are, you've already heard this, but I'm going to play a song for you called Hello in There by John Prine. And it's a bonus activity I wanted to give to all of my students. So if you are one of the few in my language arts class, that's great. You only have to do this once. You don't have to do the bonus assignment twice. You don't have to do it at all. It's not graded. I just wanted to put it out there because I think it's something thoughtful to do. I think it's the people in your lives that I'm going to talk about will really appreciate it. All right, let's review the distance learning schedule quick. Talk a little bit about how this week's different. This is your standard distance learning schedule. So we have a five-day week here. On Mondays, you're just going to be working with your 1, 2, 3, 4 classes, and that's going to be called an A day. On B days, you're going to work with your 5, 6, 7, 8 classes. So this is just a reminder that down here points out that you're only going to have two. So here's a day one and then a day two. You're going to have 2 days of content from your teachers. So they're not producing content for you Monday through Friday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. No, they're just producing 2 days of content. So, and then on Wednesday, teachers are reaching out to students directly. This week or last week, they only reached out to your parents to see what's the best way to get in touch with you. But starting on April 15th on Wednesday, your teachers are going to be reaching out to you directly, wanting to have direct conversations with you, your advisory teachers. This week looks a little different. There's no school on Friday. That means Thursday and Friday got pushed up. So the Wednesday advisory check-ins this week got moved out. And so you have A day, B day, A day, B day, and then Friday's off. All right, that's just a quick review. I might do that one more time this week, and then I'll be using that whiteboard for some other purpose. Mr. Ermer's contact information is a document you can find in Schoology inside the distance learning. Right at the top, there's some information about ways to contact me. Number one way of contact me is through my school email address. It has not failed yet. Schoology has been very inconsistent. I do see those messages. I do respond to those as soon as I see them, but there's a little bit of lag. That means that I don't get alerts about those until a little bit later. So if you want to message me right away and get a direct response as quickly as possible, go to my school email address, and I have that listed in this document. Schoology messages do work. Sometimes I have been unable to access Schoology. I know you have probably had that same experience, so just be aware of that. And then also, if you want to call me and hear me, and or you have an issue that needs a little bit more explaining than some emails and texts, that's really hard and sometimes confusing, and you just want me to explain something to you, I am welcome to talk. I'm happy to talk with you. Email me. Just say, hey, Mr. Irmer, are you free to talk now? And I'll, if it's okay with your families, check in with them. I'll give you my cell phone. We could talk, because again, one of those other things, I do have a work number they gave us that we should be able to use through our computer. It hasn't worked for me once. So, it's been very inconsistent. So if it's okay with your families, I'll give you my cell phone and you can call me out right away and we could talk through whatever issues, or explanations you want to. And that's, and that information is all in Schoology. All right. Schoology updates. Things I'm going to say about that. There's three things. One, restart your devices. I've given that suggestions to many students so far, and 95% of the time it fixes whatever issues you're having where your device is interacting with these internet apps and platforms, and restarting your device updates whatever it needs to update, and then it starts interacting and interfacing with these electronic programs a lot better. So just restart your devices. And because you're using these devices so frequently with school now, I probably get in the habit of restarting them at least once a week. Two, submitting assignments. I've had a number of people express different issues, but one, it just seems like you don't know how to submit to the assignments. So when you see an assignment, such as the Rex reflection question, click on the assignment. You should see a button in the top right that says submit. Or submissions, or respond. I think it says submit. Click on the button. It's going to open up a window. In that window, you'll see three tabs at the top. So you'll see three tabs at the top. Click on the middle one, and that will give you a text space where you can respond to the response. You can add to your 2 to 3 sentences in that text space. And then the last update about Schoology is that, yes, some of your classes are having Google assignments posted in Schoology. That's not interacting really well. We've had very low success with that. Google is aware with it. It's a Google issue, actually. And Schoology and Google are currently talking. So just wait for updates from your teachers about those. There should be some workarounds that your teachers are communicating about that. And that's Schoology. Today, don't forget to review the assignment expectations, the assignment and the project for habit forming and habit breaking, or habit breaking is in Schoology. So review today's assignment. Today's Monday. And you had an assignment over the weekend to take notes to yourself. I don't want you to submit those notes, so look at Monday's assignment. I'm asking you to be thoughtful and reflective about what kind of work you did with your habits. Were you successful? Did you fail at it? And that's okay. I want you to feel safe about failing with working it with your chosen habit. And just be honest about that in your reflection. So you don't get you don't dock points if you didn't succeed at quitting pop or going for a walk every day. Whatever it was, it's fine to fail. I fail. We all fail. And that's how we learn as people. But I want you to be honest in your reflections and your experiences. And so go into Schoology today and today's assignment. The directions are posted in Schoology and the assignment is available for you to put your thoughtful 45 sentences there. All right, the fourth agenda today is to listen to a song by John Prine. So, and why I created this bonus assignment was because we've all been socially isolating, or should be socially isolating, and some people are probably feeling a bit more isolated than others. I myself live alone in a small apartment, so I feel a little bit stir crazy myself. And so I find myself reaching out to people. And I've also been very reflective in ways that that I haven't been. And I've been reaching out to family members who are older, because I've especially concerned for that population. Older people are more susceptible to serious injury and death from COVID-19 if they can track COVID-19. So I've been thinking a lot about the people in my life who are more vulnerable than others to the dangers of COVID-19. One is my uncle I've shared with you. He was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. I reached out to him yesterday, and though he's not old, he's 67, he is struggling with terminal or deadly illness. And so I thought about how isolation must feel for him. So we talked, and I know that was really nice for both of us to reach out and just share with each other. And so there's a song it made me think about. It's called Hello In There by John Prine, my favorite singer-songwriter. And it explores this idea of loneliness, growing old, and how there's a line in there that if you're walking down the street sometime, I might butcher this a little bit, and you see some hollow ancient eyes, these old eyes, old people, stop and say hello in there. Hello. So you've got a bonus assignment in Schoology. After you listen to the song, think about it. Think about the elderly people in your life. Perhaps it's a grandparent or a great-grandparent. I just want you to be thoughtful and try to get them on the phone. Yes, we want to especially maintain social distancing from those more vulnerable populations like older people, but give them a call. That's okay to give them a call and just say hello in there. And I've got some interview questions, thoughtful interview questions that you could reach out. And I bet those elderly people in your life are going to love hearing these interview questions and sharing their stories with you, 11, 12-year-old. So in my experience as a younger person, and even now, my interactions with people that are elderly, my grandma, who recently passed, she was 93, but I'd go and visit her multiple times a year. She loved seeing me. So reach out. Here's the song. I'm gonna sit a little closer. Mic's in my headphones.
All the news. repeat himself like some forgotten dream that we've both seen. Someday I'll go and call Rudy. We work together in the factory. What can I say? He asks what's new. Nothing what's with you. Nothing much to do. You know that old trees just grow stronger. That old river grow wilder every day. Old people just grow lonesome. Waiting for someone to say hello in that. So if you're walking down the street sometime, spot some hollow ancient eyes, please don't just pass them by and stare, as if you didn't care, say hello in there.
Say hello in there. Again, I remember doing an assignment. I must have been your age. I remember we were given an assignment to interview someone who had experienced World War II. And that was really interesting. A person that was much older than me. And I was your age, 10 or 11, and it was I still have vivid memories from that. So I've got a bonus assignment. I'm not going to grade it, but I really think it's a time to reach out to those elderly people in our lives who are more vulnerable to the dangers of COVID-19 than you or I, who have healthier immune systems. With that, again, this is my favorite singer-songwriter. His family recently announced that he did contract COVID-19. They put him, he is intubated and in a stable condition, but not improving. And he is facing very serious issues right now as a result of COVID-19. He had previously battled cancer a couple of times. And so as an older person as well, in his early 70s, he's just a more vulnerable older adult. And so it's scary times. So reach out to those people that are elderly in your life and just say hello in there and be there. And that'll bring a smile and be a delight for them. So again, you've got a bonus assignment. I would appreciate it if you did that. And we're thoughtful for those older people in your lives. And then think about your habits. Keep working with those. The directions are still posted in Schoology. You know what to do. And today you have an assignment for Monday to post about your experiences over the weekend, the past few days of working with developing new habits or breaking old ones. Great to see everybody.